This video will not only satisfy your fantasy and fiction appetite, but will also plunge you into the imagination of endless affirmative possibilities in this world. Our story begins from the early discovery of sunlight in this world. Sunlight, a luminous electromagnetic wave that transmits between all of us. But what is the medium for its transmission? Is it us? Only particles following refractory phenomena or something else too? How come it has no effect on the gravitational force of our planet? Or does it? With such curious doubts out there, gave path to the theories of an ether. Ether has many definitions changing from culture to culture. In Greek mythology, ether means the top regions of the air past the sky, the upper air gods of Olympus breathe. According to scientific clarification, an ether is a house-filling substance or field essential as a transmission medium for propagation of electromagnetic or gravitational forces. In the 19th century, luminiferous ether means light-bearing ether was a theorized medium for the propagation of light. Our scientists called it electromagnetic radiation. However, a series of increasingly complex experiments had been carried out in the late 1800s, like the Michelson-Morley experiment, in an attempt to detect the motion of Earth through the ether, and had failed to do so. A range of proposed ether-dragging theories could explain the null result, but these were more complex and tended to use arbitrary-looking coefficients and physical assumptions. Many experiments were proposed, and all of those experiments focused only on the materialistic ether, which is an impossible thing, because ether doesn't belong to this dimension. The dimension you and me are living in is the three-dimensional world, where ether has its contribution, but it doesn't exist here. Scientist with the name Joseph Larmor discussed the ether in terms of a moving magnetic field caused by the acceleration of electrons. James Clerk Maxwell said of the ether, "In several parts of this treatise, an attempt has been made to explain electromagnetic phenomena by means of mechanical action transmitted from one body to another by means of a medium occupying the space between them. The undulatory theory of light also assumes the existence of a medium. We have now to show that the properties of electromagnetic medium are identical with those of the luminiferous medium. That means that they agreed to the fact that there is some medium which is carrying our light, or should say an energy, from one point to another point when it comes to electromagnetism. But they failed in proving so in a mathematical and scientific way. In the year 1887, an experiment known as Michelson-Morley experiment proved that ether does not exist. It proved that there is no particular evidence in any material form that can justify the existence of an ether. This is the truth. Because ether doesn't exist in the three-dimensional world you and me are living in. And science is all about studying materialistic and three-dimensional things by observing them. So it is clear that it is impossible even today to clearly proof that ether does exist. From the 16th until the late 19th century, gravitational phenomena had also been modeled utilizing an ether. The most well-known formulation is Lessig's theory of gravitation. Although other models were proposed by Isaac Newton, Bernhard Riemann, and Lord Kelvin, none of those concepts are considered to be viable by the scientific community today. But still, modern scientists have a small hope that ether does exist, and this is due to the statement given by Carl Sagan. As Carl Sagan said, which I quote, "Absence of evidence is not evidence of absence," which explains space is endowed with physical qualities, and therefore there exists ether. Because ether is something which is not completely absent from this dimension, but is absent in the materialistic form. So it is not possible to prove it scientifically with the technology we have today. And he also clearly stated that space without ether is unthinkable, because for in such space there would be no propagation of light if ether did not exist. Ether may not be thought as endowed with the quality of ponderable media, but it does exist. Many fiction writers understood this fact and started writing their own science fiction dramas on it. According to some fiction writers, ether exists and is a both source and destination to the subconscious and conscious thoughts of a being. So, is the ether the dimension of origin of our thoughts? Do our thoughts originate from this dimension known as ether? Try to discover this imaginary illusion and you will find that there is an energy that connects us all. Is it heaven? Or is it a dimension far ahead of this present technology? Almost feels like science fiction or fantasy drama, right? No matter what you call it, the energy of your thought or the energy of your consciousness, but it does exist. It could be someone on your team or someone you don't know at all. When you see him, you will establish contact with him in an invisible way of thinking. And then when you talk to him, you will be able to understand his mentality, and when you are speaking, you will be able able to predict what your conversation will be like and where it is going to end. This happened because you sneaked into his mind for a while. And how did you do it? By using this ether. Perhaps, in fact, ether is a medium between us, which can help us find synchronization points in dialogues and thought. Perhaps this is how we communicated as Homo habilis in our initial stages of evolution, the first stage of learning Homo sapiens communicating through sign language. And maybe this is why humans cannot understand the language of other animals on this planet, because our thoughts can have a higher frequency response than that of animals. This has played a fundamental role in the development of our civilization in many respects. The development we have achieved is not the product of the language we communicate. It is the product of the thoughts we share through our thought. Until thought and the power of thought are fully explored by us. And this concept of ether will remain a museum-sized painting in the minds of novel and fantasy readers. However, reality is always stranger than fiction. Therefore, we must see what more perfect positive possibilities can be realized in the next 50 years of our development. Perhaps after we understand the technology, neural links will be the key to understanding the ether, in which people can simply use their thoughts to share their opinion. I presume that there will be brain-to-brain frequency connection between people increases privacy. But privacy may also include some negative plans of its owner. Therefore, if this technology comes into being, it is best to eliminate it. Because we humans have our own masks in our society. Because all of us have a selfish side. And we humans have our own mask in our society. Not everyone does it, but people in overcoats may have a selfish side. Who knows? We all want to grow. Don't we all want to make a profit? But if there is such a thing, it has already produced positive benefits for our civilization. And if some of us plan to profit from things that are already gifted to mankind, therefore ether must be absolutely hidden or unknown. And this gift that we have can be used to communicate with people, laugh with them and sympathize with them. Because the only way we can increase the strings, I call it the threads of life in our lives, is to spread positivity. Praise others, share love, express love. One day, my friend, you will leave this world. Thanks to our thinking and human consciousness, we can stay alive in the thoughts of people we praised and spread our positivity. This keeps the legends alive in our hearts. Therefore, remember, my friend, to actively strengthen this world, because the most important thing in life is how you connect with people, you know, through your thoughts. So, be positive, grow positive, and have a great day. Signing off, Skill Beings.